Today we are going to save about 200 euros on a new battery for our boat, or much more in preventing our boat from burning. I don't know, 1 million euros. Well, that's if you have a huge boat, and if not, then 1,000 euros if you have a very modest one. Because today we are going to see how we can monitor the status of the batteries of our boat, caravan or whatever, from our home for about 15 euros. With a little device that surprised me, and that we will see, can help us become intelligent and automate many onboard systems in a super easy way. The Shelly UNI.
Shelly UNI? But is it Chinese?
I'm not going to reveal it to you yet. Greetings, sailors, and welcome to a new episode of the Low-Cost Sailor. Today we are going to see how simple and economical it can be to monitor our boat's batteries from anywhere, receiving alerts on our mobile phone about low battery, overload, overheating, and even being able to act on the boat's system. For example, disconnecting the battery from the mains to isolate it in case of emergency. All this thanks to a multifunction gadget, a development board called Shelly UNI that has a little bit of everything to help us make a lot of inventions and automations for our boat. And all this can be yours for just around 15 euros. We will guide you through the entire process of creating a remote battery monitor, and that's not all. We will also unveil a world of simple inventions that can be fashioned using the same board, whether it be keeping a close eye on the various systems of your boat or vehicle, or even constructing nifty contraptions like a boat refrigerator or a smart switch panel. The possibilities are endless. Don't pass up this wonderful opportunity, as this device is extremely user-friendly, versatile, and within reach for anyone. If you've been hesitant to dabble in the realm of electronics, this introductory project is the perfect stepping stone for you.
But you haven't told me yet if it's Chinese or not Chinese.
I'm not going to tell you yet. Have you asked me 1 million times? And a little device that allows me to see the status of my batteries from home? Something simple and already done?
1 million times. Maybe I exaggerate them a little because we don't have 1 million subscribers. Unless there has been one who has said it many times.
Well, 1 million times. Million up, million down.
Plus or minus 1 million.
Plus or minus 1 million. We have shown you a lot of devices, especially to talk to the Tuya Smart application to automate everything you can imagine. Door and window sensors, flood detectors, relays for control panels, gas detectors, smoke detectors, smart plugs. A lot of devices that have been very useful for our boat throughout the channel episodes and extremely cheap. And we have already insisted on how important it is to know the status of our batteries in several episodes of the channel. When we bought, for example, the Chinese battery monitor, which has been out in the open on my boat for almost 3 years and continues to work perfectly without any sign of deterioration or anything more complicated, connecting them to the Raspberry Pi and showing all its information on Signal K. But even more important is to know the status of our batteries when we are not on board. Either because we have the boat anchored or disconnected from the electrical grid, we are far from home and we want to prevent them from over-discharging and then ending up damaged, or because we leave them plugged in and charging and we do not want any failure in the charger to cause an overload. That could end in fire. And I speak this last from experience. But something as simple as a battery voltage meter that worked over Wi-Fi and could transmit that data over Wi-Fi did not appear in any of my AliExpress searches. Oh my God, the Chinese are faster than me. Come on, while we were recording this episode, I have already seen that they have even brought out a little device to do this. Of course, it costs 50 bucks and does not measure temperature. But hey, maybe in another episode we'll take a look at it. At the moment, the best Shelly, it works for everything. In the forum of the Port Tavern, which is where one of the forum members, a peasant, opened my eyes to the existence of this little thing. The truth is that if you don't use the Port Tavern forum, don't wait. It's a great place full of good people willing to help with this nautical thing, although from time to time they scold me for posting one of my videos. If you write it, okay, if you do it on video, and that's how I discovered the Shelly UNI with which today we are going to build a battery monitor that tells us the voltage and temperature of our batteries at all times and allows us very easily receive alarms on our mobile in case something goes wrong with the battery. Just in case, first of all, I want to tell you that this episode was not sponsored by anyone.
Don't lie, don't lie. This episode has clearly been sponsored. It has been sponsored by our Patreon patrons, our three Patreon patrons.
This episode is being sponsored by Santiago, Garmenon, and Ro, our three Patreon sponsors who give up a beer every month so we can tell you about inventions like these. I can tell you that my opinion and experience could not be more sincere. The Shelly UNI is a small and economical development board designed to automate and convert all types of devices that work with direct current into smart ones. It has two digital outputs with which to control relays, an analog input that supports voltages between 0 and 30 volts, two digital inputs with which, for example, can read the status of a switch or check if a device is on or off, and a bus one wire that allows you to connect up to three simultaneous temperature sensors. And all this can be powered between 12 and 36 volts, which in reality we will see later that it also works with 10 volts. The first thing that will surprise you the most, especially Carlos, is that for once, and without serving as a precedent, it is not Chinese. It costs less than 15 euros, and it is not Chinese. Shelly is a company from Bulgaria that is dedicated to making all types of home automation devices, very much in the style of what we have seen that works with Tuya Smart. But that has its own application, and from what I have seen so far, it is very well thought out. The most innovative thing is that among its devices is the Shelly UNI, which is designed for electronic DIY, and the best of all is that it is designed for boats, motorhomes, and all those things that we like that work at 12 and 24 volts. Shelly has a wide list of distributors around the world and in Spain with several online stores. In my case, I bought it on Amazon. To make the battery monitor, we are going to need the Shelly UNI, a one-wire DS18B20 temperature probe, some cable to make the connections, and some way to protect the Shelly UNI when you install it, for example, a small box or something like that. We leave you the links to everything in the video description and in the post on our website. Regarding the purchase of the Shelly UNI, you will see that there is a new version of the Shelly UNI called the Shelly Plus UNI, and that adds a pulse counter input and the possibility of powering it at 5 volts. Tempting, but at the moment I don't recommend it since my experience has been disastrous. Of course, what you have to keep in mind is that both are delicate devices with few protections, but the Shelly Plus didn't even last 5 minutes powered at 12 volts, and I have had a lot of similar experiences with it. So it still needs a little filming or some revision or something. Thank goodness I bought it on Amazon and have been able to return it without problems. Well, I returned it defective because it didn't last 5 minutes.
It did not meet specifications.
However, with the Shelly UNI, the experience has been very good. So much so that I have already purchased two. And the time has come to assemble everything so that it fulfills its function. The truth is that converting it into a battery monitor is very simple. Of course, it is not that it stands out for its extensive documentation. In the box itself, they have taken the opportunity to indicate which function corresponds to each of the cables, and once the box is opened, we simply have the Shelly UNI, which is really small. My first piece of advice to avoid breaking anything is to cut all the cables a little so that they are no longer bare. I have already told you that all the electronics are in the air, and it is easy to play two cables that you shouldn't, and the board will be damaged. As our objective is to measure the voltage of the battery and at the same time measure its temperature, and for all this to reach the mobile phone, the circuit that we are going to assemble is going to be extremely simple, as you can see in this diagram that will appear on the screen. We will feed it directly from the battery to be measured through the positive red cable and the negative black cable. We will be able to do it with both 12 volt and 24 volt batteries. We have tested it in the range of 8 volts to 30 volts, and it works without problem. The maximum consumption of the Shelly is less than 1 watt. We are talking about 0.02 amps at 12 volts. To measure the battery voltage, we are going to use the white wire, which is the analog input, and the green wire, which is the reference ground. In our case, since we are going to measure the same battery with which we are going to power it, we can connect white with red and black with green. With this, we can measure the voltage of our battery and send it via Wi-Fi over the internet to our mobile phone. But as a safety measure and taking into account the cost of a temperature probe, I would also connect a temperature probe to measure the temperature of the battery. Once again, super simple. The probe comes with three red and black power cables and yellow data cables. We can connect the black cable of the probe with the GND, that is, with the green cable, and therefore also with the black cable. The red cable on the probe is the power supply, but be careful, the probe is not powered at 12 volts or at 24, but at 5, so we will have to power it with the yellow cable from the Shelly, which is the power supply for the sensors. Finally, the yellow cable of the probe is connected connected to the Shelly data cable, which is the blue cable, and that's it. Everything is ready, so we can power it and check it properly. One of the things I like most about the Shelly UNI is that it is perfectly designed to be able to work both on a network with and without an internet connection. Without needing an internet connection, we will be able to see all your data through a web browser or integrate it with our Raspberry, configure it and everything. By default, it comes in AP mode and we can connect to its Wi-Fi. You will see that the network calls Shelly and some numbers appear, and by connecting to them and opening the address 192.168.30.30.1 in the browser, a screen will appear with all the information and we will be able to configure it and do everything about it. But our main objective is to monitor the batteries from home, and for that we will want to have the Shelly connected to a Wi-Fi network with internet. We have already made several videos on how to have internet on board, from freeloading the neighbor's Wi-Fi to connecting via satellite with Starlink. But once you have a Wi-Fi network with an internet connection to be able to configure the Shelly easily, we will need to install the Shelly Smart application on our mobile. Once installed, we will have to register with an email and we can start playing. With the Shelly board powered, we go to the application and say that we want to add a new device. We want to do it through Wi-Fi. It will ask us for permissions to access the Wi-Fi. It will immediately find our Shelly. We click on it, and it will ask us for the data of the Wi-Fi to which we want to connect. After a minute of this, it will have connected correctly to it, and it will ask us to assign a name and an icon to our Shelly. And that's it. In devices, we will see two devices. In reality, they are two channels corresponding to each of the two relays that the Shelly has. There we have buttons to turn the relays on and off, see the battery value, the current temperature, and the status of the digital inputs. There are two things that we are going to do at the beginning. By clicking on the device and on the configuration wheel, we can configure many things. But the first thing we are going to do is configure the ADC range with 30 volts, so that it is able to make measurements from 0 to 30 instead of 0 to 12, so that it can work well with the battery voltages that many times will be above 12 volts, even if they are 12. The second thing I recommend is to update the firmware to the latest version. There is nothing left to do. You can take the phone home or from the boat itself. From anywhere, you will be able to check the voltage, the battery, and its temperature. You can even add all this data to the dashboard, which is the main entry screen of the application. But of course, I imagine that you will have better things to do than staring at the mobile screen all day to see if the battery is okay. So we can also easily create alerts to notify us in case something happens. For example, voltage that is too low, meaning that the battery is running out, as it is bad for batteries to discharge excessively. Voltage that is too high, as dangerous as it is for a battery to be overcharged, begins to release hydrogen and the risk of explosion if it is acid-based, or it can be stored and heated if it is lithium. We also have the thermometer to see the excessively high temperature. It is a clear indicator of a fire risk or the excessively low temperature. For LiFePO4 batteries and lithium batteries, it can be a problem because these batteries have a charging range that at low temperatures we should stop charging them. Química, química. Well, when any of those things happen, we can easily send a notification to our cell phone. In Shelly's application, we click on the little house, we go to the third tab. We may have to first click on the second so we can see the third. In all scenes, we give the button to add XC. The first thing it will ask us to do is add a condition. It will be a condition based on device. We look for our device. We will get two for each Shelly. We click on it, and now we choose the data that we are going to use in our case. For example, ADC detection, and here we can set the voltage that we consider limit. For example, for an acid battery, it is worrying when its voltage is below 12 volts. That means that the battery is already below 40% and can be a problem. We say that this condition is going to trigger the scene and we click save. We click next, add action, we choose to notify action, and here we can choose several options. The simplest notification is by phone, although we can also do it by email. We put a message that will come to us with the notification like the battery is too low and we choose it to be an alarm. What this is going to give you is a different sound that we can customize and that will be much more striking. Finally, it asks us how long the situation has to be in that state for it to send the alarm. For example, we want it to notify us when the battery is 10 seconds or 30 seconds below 12 volts to eliminate peaks, for example, from the ignition of the refrigerator compressor or the water pump that can cause the battery to drop for an instant. Battery. We click on save. Next, we deactivate the option to run the scene when saving. We associate it with an instance and we give it a name and an icon, and that's it. We can activate or deactivate it if we don't want it to bother us, and we can even check the notification by pressing play. Although, of course, the best way is to check by making the action happen. In our case, it is very easy with our power supply that we can lower the voltage until it jumps. And that's it. We can repeat all this for the maximum battery values, or the maximum temperature, or the minimum temperature, many more times. When it comes to doing the final installation, this is going to be very simple. We can solder and protect the assembly of all the cables, leaving it a little tidier and better, obtaining on the one hand the positive cable that will go to the battery and the negative that will go to the negative of the battery. In the same way, we have the temperature zone, and we can either put this set in a little box. I leave you some links in the description of the little boxes that we use, for example, for the controls or other similar ones in which it can fit very well. If you don't want to put it in a little box, well, you could protect it with insulating tape, or the simplest thing is to just put it all in a heat shrinkable film, and it will be as compact as possible.
Heat
shrinkable film is wonderful.
He fixes everything with silicone.
In fact, you can use the silicone gun to glue it to the box, to the plate. Your wife is an intelligent person. I have already told you that you can also access all this data and configurations with a web browser at the IP address that your router has assigned to the Shelly. You have an interface with multiple utilities. Basically, see all the data and configure a lot of things. Among them, one of the possibilities that I like the most is to invoke a URL on the internet or on our local network when an alarm situation occurs, or with each message received. That opens up a world of possibilities for us, from setting off alarms, making cell phone calls, everything. It also opens the possibility of integrating it with our Raspberry Pi through calls to a non-network or on the signal card. But the Shelly UNI hardware is also very versatile. Any of the digital inputs can be used, for example, to connect a bilge float, the kind we use in some of our episodes, which detects when there is water in the bilge and sends an alert to our cell phone immediately. Or we can use those same inputs to detect when something is working, since they are set to 1 with any voltage above 2.2 volts. Thus, for example, and together with its relay outputs, we could control, by adding a power relay, any switch on our switch panel. Imagine even using it as a thermostat for our refrigerator and controlling whether it is operating at this temperature. A world of possibilities. Rest assured that we will make another video with her. Share your ideas and needs or suggestions in the comments, and we will see if they are interesting enough to implement in a new episode.
Quickie, that makes a good scratch, eh?
My goodness, that sun doesn't heat up. That sun doesn't heat up. Well, you have seen. The truth is that I love discovering this toy. Well, you have discovered it to me. I have many ideas. But you contribute a lot with your ideas, whether in the forums, in the comments, everywhere. And I think that the Shelly UNI is going to give me a lot of use. And above all, that many things that I have done can be done with the Shelly UNI in a way that may be much simpler for you. I think it is the first opportunity that you have not dared to experiment. The first opportunity to experiment is this 15 euro gadget that if you fry one, well, 15 euros that you have lost. You can buy it from the links in the description on Amazon anywhere and play with it. Thank you very much for your attention, navigators. I hope you liked today's episode. If so, please give us a like, subscribe to the channel. You have the bell to receive notifications. You have all the links in the video description and on our website, www.thelowcostsailor.com. I especially want to thank everyone who is supporting the channel, those who have signed up for Patreon and are already starting to support us so that we can continue making these episodes, and people who have supporting us from the beginning, like Alphonse donating through PayPal, and every month he is very happily buying us a beer. So thank you all very much. I hope the day comes when we are a lot of people and we can dedicate ourselves to thinking crazy things and doing crazy things and make inventions of this. In any case, we continue working. We continue working. We will see you in a couple of weeks in a new episode of The Low-Cost Sailor.
Is Bulgaria the new China?
I don't know, but they do good things. I'm telling you, don't buy the Plus just yet.